everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video I will be doing a get ready with me for work video, and I'm not gonna make this a long intro, so I'm just gonna go ahead and jump right into the video. So let's get into it. Okay, first we're gonna use my Milk hydro primer and go ahead and set it. I'm gonna put them in a spot. You guys, I bumped my head. I don't know if you guys can see like a redness right here, but it's already swelling up. Like how did it have an effect? You see it? I bumped my head trying to get my lashes. How? Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyebrows off camera and I'll be right back. Okay, so I did my eyebrows. They're gonna be the best as I know how, because I am a little in a rush. So wait, that'll make sense. I am in a rush. Now I'm going to do my eyes. So I already prepped it with the e.l.f. concealer. Now I'm about to go in and do my eyes. So first I'm going to start off with this shade here, and it's called Extra Spice, or Extra Spicy. I'm gonna place it kind of close up to my eyebrow and try to faint it out a little bit more in like that corner top part, and then try to fade it out kind of going over into like the middle. I am going to go in with the butter, this shade here, and it's called Butterscotch. I'm going to place that a little like in that crease, in my crease, just a little bit. Just gonna keep it right here. Kind of like giving like that sunset fade look here. Now I'm going to go in with this Soft and Sweet shade here. It's like a blush, like a mauve pink. Yeah, like a mauve pink. And just place that all over at the bottom, even in the center of my eye. I'm gonna go back into that butterscotch and kind of do this as again. Put it back like just in the corner of my eye. I'll take this brush here. It's like a small yet tapered brush. And I'm gonna go into like my dark brown shade, which is the Cookie Call. I'm gonna take that brown and put it just at my lower lash here. I'm not gonna bring it too far over. Just gonna keep it in my lower lash. And kind of wing it out a bit. This more of a fluffy small brush here, I'm gonna fade that brown. That I placed on my lower lash. All right, next I'm going to go in my Too Faced Tickle Peach palette and go into this shade that I stay using. And I'm going to place that up here underneath my eyebrow, I think. Like that. It's not too much. I'm just gonna take this same brush and like fade out this here. Kind of push that up. Back up in here. I'm also going to go into this shade right here and place that in the center, so it's like the same color as that mauve pink in my Too Faced Spice palette. I'm just going to take that, give like a little shimmer look here, and just place that in the center. Kind of blend all that together here. And then a little bit in the extra spice, just to kind of darken it back out some more. I'm not gonna put any underneath my lower lash. I'm just gonna keep it like this, almost like that simple look at the top of my lashes. And this mascara is from Maybelline. I like this mascara a lot actually, because it really does separate your lashes. I'm gonna go ahead and pop my lashes on and I'll be right. All right, I have my lashes on and I'm telling you guys, lashes make a huge difference for the face. I'm so serious. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and apply my Too Faced Born This Way concealer that I use as a foundation because I love it. And I do not use a whole lot. I just place it on my complexion brush and the concealer all over it because it has this wand, so that's why. But or sometimes I just place it on my face and I just put it in the places where I mostly need it. A little bit does goes a long way for me, especially in the workplace. You don't need a whole lot because, you know, you're at work. And by me being at work, I'm gonna be here for about a couple of hours. So I do want my foundation slash concealer, or concealer slash foundation, to hold up long enough until I can get home and take it off. So what I love about this Too Faced Born This Way concealer, for me, foundation, it is full coverage and it's definitely have like that creamy feel to it, but it's not too crazy where it starts to melt off your face and stuff like that. It doesn't. So I definitely love this for that reason. It does give you like that flawless filter look to the face when you are applying it on, when you have it on. This is just a really good all over concealer, and I can just imagine how the foundation is when I do get it because I already love the concealer. And as you guys can see, that flawless look as if I got like a filter on. Love, love, love this concealer so much. Next, I'm going to go in my favorite Ace Beauty Bronze and Paradise palette. This is how the shades look. very beautiful. I'm about to take this brush here. I got from my Ipsy box before when I had Ipsy, and just place, just so I just dab one and one, two dab in that on that side. So I kind of like mix them together and just place it on my forehead in the areas where I want bronzed. And I love this bronze as well because it does also give me like that flawless, non-cakey look to my face. Gives me that nice bronze look. As you guys can see, it's not too heavy, not too crazy or anything like that. It just really does the job. And it doesn't lift up the product that I place underneath at all. The formulation is great. It's like almost like buttery, but it also kind of have like that, it has like a little bit of this butter texture to it as well. It's not too buttery where you can like feel it and press into it and you can like see your fingerprint in it. No, it still have like that pressed powder chalk feel to it, but a smidge, like the undertone of it, of the formula, is kind of buttery where it just glides on your face without feeling so chalky or dry or like lifting up the products that you did place underneath it, like your foundation and your concealer. So that's one thing I do love about this palette from Ace Beauty. So I place it in these areas, forehead, cheek, under here, and then jawline. So I get my perfect contour. And then I'm gonna get this brush, and this is from Lush. This is a taper blending brush I got from my BoxyCharm. I'm gonna take this shade here and a little bit, one dab of this shade, and just contour my nose. I'm just gonna bring it up here, start close to my eyebrows, and blend it in so it gives me like this nice sharp swoop look to my nose, like my nose itself is contoured. And then I'm just gonna bring it down a smidge. Next, I'm going to take my Fit Me by Maybelline. I'm going to take this brush here, dab a little bit in there, and then just bring it down the nose. Like this. And kind of flare it out up here. Then next I'm going to go in with my concealer and just put a little bit here, not too much because I don't really need a whole lot, and just thank you. And then next I'm going to take that same powder here, dab just a little bit in that, and place it like this, just press it into my skin so that it can just really like just set it all in place, and then kind of like blur it out a bit. Also take some and put it where I applied that concealer on my nose, like this. And just like dust off the rest. Do the same on this side. Place a little bit here, just a little over here as well. On my forehead. I'm going to take my NYX spray. This is the Set Refresher and Primer Spray. Yes. Same brush here, and just apply. Like, just push it all into the skin and where I place every single product on my face. Just add, put a little bit more here in the center, and just press all that in together. Yeah, so I am going to get a little bit of blush, just a little bit. I'm gonna use this blush palette from Wonder Beauty, and this is how it looks, this blush here, and just press it into that, and then press it on to my face. So it gives me a little bit of color, but not too much, because I don't want to look like the 70s or 80s, no offense, but no. And just place that on there. I just want to look like I'm woke, but not like excitedly woke. So like that. I'm gonna set a little bit more because I did add that blush. I want the blush to like blend in with the skin and not just like sit on top of my skin. Yeah. Now I'm going to take this fan brush, dip it in this little palette here for my highlighters, my Too Faced Tickle Peach, and just place a little bit just up top right here, nowhere else. Well, just here. And my higher cheek, sorry, not even in the camera, like in my high cheek bone area. Just keep it up there. Take this same brush, and this brush is by the Luxie brand. Just place a little bit on the nose, the tip of my nose, and then down the bridge. So the tip, then the bridge. And blend all that with my finger. I am going to place a little bit in the corner of my eyes, like the tear dots, I meant to say. So I'm going to take the same pencil from LA Girl, yeah, and place it on. kind of smear it together. Now I'm just gonna take some gloss. This is the Maybelline gloss. I love this gloss so much. It's very hydrating. It's like that pinky, blush pink tone to the gloss, and just place it on my lips. My finger and kind of smear it around like this. Do like my last spray. I use this a lot, so. And that is the end of my look.
Before you came round, my heart would never be much faster. Before you came round.
Alright you guys, so this is the end of my video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I did. I'll see you guys in my next one. Please like, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell so you guys be notified when I upload another video. I'm off to work, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Remember, always speak positive, never negative. I'll see you guys later. Bye.